Thank you. National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, in USA announced, quote, "We have already officially crossed the climate change tipping point," unquote. The temperature of the world is rising each year, each decade, and each century. The consequences of global warming is huge. I want to mention some of them. Too cold and too hot. As the temperature is rising, we are getting too hot. At the same time, we are getting cold. Because due to the rise of the temperature, the sea ice, the ice of the Antarctica and the Greenland has been melting down. And some part of the world is getting colder and some part of the world getting hotter. Extreme temperature, extreme weather we'll get. The sea level of the world will increase as well due to the temperature rise, melting down the ice. When the sea level increases, many coastal countries will be submerged, like Maldives, some part of Bangladesh, even some part of United States like Florida. There will be mass migration due to climate change. The food production will be declined dramatically. In Bangladesh, Maldives, Nigeria, Cuba, Haiti, and many other countries. And they will be forced to leave their country. And the developing countries need at least $100 billion to offset the negative aspects and consequences of climate change. The developed countries will also face this experience. The price of the goods, especially the food products, will be rising by 80%, according to World Bank, by 2050. And the ecosystem will be dysfunctional. When temperature rises, many species will be extinct, and the food chain will be disturbed. Fishing economy will be collapsed. Why we don't take care of the climate change very efficiently, and why we don't take it seriously? There are some threat indicators. That's why people don't take it importantly, seriously. First of all, we respond to the threats that are visible. But climate change is invisible. We respond to the threats that are immediate. But climate change is drawn out years, decades, and even centuries. We respond to the threats that are personal and direct. But climate change is unpredictable and maybe indirect. We respond to the threats that has historical precedence, but climate change is unprecedented. We respond to the threats that has simple causality, but climate change has complex causality. We respond to the threats that seems to be simple, but not very simple. We respond to the threats that are caused by an enemy, but climate change is caused by all of us. How we can cope up with the climate change and how we can take the proper decisions. What will be the proper decisions? How we can take the challenges? My opinion is that we can take the fee and dividend policies to reduce the global warming. What is the policy? The policy is that to put a fee on the carbon dioxide content of fossil fuel. And the money collected from the fees will be distributed among the legal residents of the United States. But there will be some problem. When this fee will be charged, the export of the United States will be expensive. Then another policy can be taken to introduce extra tariff or tax on import. And how this policy can affect our life? The fossil fuel will be expensive for the fee, and we'll be more interested to use the renewable energy. Most people will be benefited from this policy than they pay. And the clean energy innovation and investment will be dramatically changed, and there will be renaissance. And an economic study showed that if this policy will be adopted, about 52% of employment, 52% of carbon dioxide emission will be reduced, and about 2.8 million jobs will be created, 1.4 economic growth will be earned by the United States. So please set your tipping point for climate change. Thank you so much.